Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real time. I feel alive. And the world, I'll turn it inside out. Yeah. I'm floating around in a seesaw. Stop now. Stop. 'Cause I'm having a time. Having a time. You shouldn't start leaping through the sky.
We have gone ahead and muted Toa because he literally interrupted the intro just as it finished with his phone. You would think by now he would know to mute his phone or turn it down. It is absolutely shameless that he did not mute his phone. I am not muting my phone at this time as I'm talking. However,
yes, you should always mute your phone. Don't let it ever make noise like that.
My mother with groceries, so.
Wow!
Still, turn your freaking phone off. Or not off, but silent.
Or vibrate it. Actually, don't vibrate it.
My phone's always on vibrate, so people wonder whenever we get a lot of messages about something going.
In any case, everybody, welcome to the Brony Show. 407 episodes, and we still have yet to do one where we don't screw up at some point. Of course, I am your host as always, drinking a wonderful cup of Twilight Sparkle tea. I am Circuit Main, but I am not here alone. I have with me a great panel of great bronies who have stuck through this thick and thin somehow, for some reason. But we're still going to bring him in anyway because I love that kind of dedication. We have Deathlight Productions.
Hey.
Oh, and we also have a DM21 jumping in early this time.
Well, I won't be here for long. Well, audibly.
Ah, fair enough.
I won't be hopping back on for the game, though.
That is definitely fair enough. And we have Textalion.
Which it's raining here, so if I disconnect, that's why.
Oh, you too?
It's not raining for us, but it's got a nice cloud coverage, and oh, the weather is looking to dip nice and low for the next few days, which is going to suck when it starts to come back up to the 90s by the weekend. Why? Why did you tease us with fall just to rip it away? Whether you can take us... Yeah, anyway, and we also have Toakoi.
Mother Nature's cruel. What else?
Okay, well, Toakoi was already audible, so we already know he's here, but it looks like he's away for the moment. And we have, of course, the man of stakes, the health aficionado, the anime opinionado. What the? You know, sometimes I just wonder if I let my brain go, what it would come up with. But I'm also scared.
Be careful of that.
I'm also very scared of that. But in either case, we do have Suki of the Otaku Ascended.
Also, bullshit. I know next to nothing about health.
Considering
I'm flying by the seat of my pants.
Dude, that's actually 20%. That's 50% better than most. That's a lot.
I know what I'm supposed to do, but I don't do it half the time.
Same here.
All right. But yes, welcome to the Brony Show. And this is the last day of August, surprisingly enough. Apparently, August went forever. And it has taken its
time. I don't know about you, but it went by in a flash for me.
I wanted it to. I kind of did. It took its time, and it dragged, and it made everything suck. August sucked this month. August sucked this month. You know that? I can't wait for August for next month. I'm sure August next month.
I won't miss the summer heat.
August 32nd. Here we go.
August 30th. August 2. Electric Skidaloo. August the sequel. We're going for August the sequel.
I have moved a house around just to get stuff taken care of today. Now, the good news, I got my Gundams. Yay, Gundam.
Well, I guess we'll say that that's our beginning for What's Up, Brony. So, tell our goddess What's Up, Brony out of the way. Let me go ahead and share a little bit with mine, because it is a little bit show interest here. Well, first off, the initial announcement, since it is the last day of August, we are still doing Tabletop Simulator. So we are going to do one more Brony-inspired game on Tabletop Simulator. And this one is actually quite interesting, because you can actually buy physical packs and expansions from Sky Railroad, who actually has their own website that is going to be in our show notes if you are at all interested after seeing this game. And he also shows up at a lot of Brony and furry conventions. So, you know, you might have already seen his stuff. He actually has the docky that's the train docky.
Oh.
I might have run into him at the last Brony con, given how Cole is.
Oh, no, yeah. He was definitely at the BronyCon.
Just a reminder that the Pony Wars collectible card game Kickstarter is ending very soon.
Ooh, good point. Yeah, could you grab me the Kickstarter link for that, and I can throw that
it's
up
already
here?
In the gaming channel in the Brony Show Discord. I'll post it here, too.
Excellent. Oh, no, I got it from there. That's all I need. Okay. Oh, yeah, it's got about a week left to go. All right, so I'll make a quick announcement. Talk about that in a quick moment here. But like I said, quick moment on the soapbox, and this does kind of concern the Brony Show in a slight off way. Those of you who know, my work has been kind of in an interesting area for the last little while. Needless to say, it's probably been the most relaxed several months I've had for any job ever, and as much as I would love for it to continue, and I would continue it forever, I really would. Unfortunately, good things must end, and in a few weeks, I actually have to start working. Now that doesn't mean much to you guys, but because of the way that the job is set up, my hours are going to be changing.
Not to mention the flu season's got to crank up again.
Oh, that's not my problem.
Yeah, not my problem either.
I'm teleworking for the most part, and I barely get out of the house because of Celestia's pancake madness, so I don't think flu is going to really do too much in my regard. But, the people I'm going to be talking with aren't exactly going to be affected by the flu, aren't going to be dealing with flu issues, they're dealing with more with mobility issues. So, more
hopefully
like if their cell phone gets dropped. We're already dealing with Celestia's pancake madness around the world. They're going to have issues regardless, but hopefully it doesn't escalate. Hopefully Celestia doesn't find out where the powdered sugar is, or else the pancake madness will only get worse.
She loves cake. Of course she's got to find where it is.
But it's pancakes we're talking about.
What you do is you put a thing of peanut butter, some powdered sugar, another layer, and stack it.
All right, but in any case, getting back on track here. So the big change is that my work is going to be a couple of hours later in the day. In all honesty, I'm really, really excited for this. The big reason I am excited for this is I don't have to get up at 5 in the morning anymore. Instead, it will be at 7, about 7-ish in the morning. Unless I just...
You working?
Say what?
And how late are you working?
They're putting me at a full hour lunch, so it's going to be an 8-to-5 position. And the show for me the show for me starts at 7 p.m. So you can kind of see that I got a little bit less time to get things prepped up. So essentially, it's going to boil down to a lot of what I used to do for the show, which is getting the show notes done a day early. It's going to affect me doing anything with the pre-show guys. I might still be able to do that. I also want to try to get working out again. I forgot to do that. Anyway, sorry.
If you have a day before, you might want to do it 2 days before the show if that doesn't work out for you.
I honestly say
7 days before. No. I was talking about on Sunday.
If you are about to put words in my mouth, you are wrong.
No.
I say do the 2 days like Death was saying, but update it as we give you stuff because people do add stuff.
I was talking about doing it the day prior on a Sunday, man. I mean, getting the show notes ready and everything. So essentially, what it boils down to is pre-show, I might be a little less frequent. The main show will still continue to go on as is. However, I'm also not going to be ridiculously tired for the after party either. And hopefully, maybe things will be a little bit more organized now that I got to get things done a day early. So the show is still going to go on. Nothing's really going to change as far as immediate stuff, but you might see some slight alterations here and there. I know, planning ahead is scaring me. I'm actually terrified. I got my drawing done at 8 o'clock this morning instead of doing it within 15 minutes before the show starts. I actually spent my time and made sure and got details in it. I'm scared. Speaking of which, okay, but yeah, that's my little bit of soapbox there. A little quick shout out though to Coldust. Unfortunately, pre-show did not happen today. Poor Coldust, unfortunately, is having some issues at home. We're hoping for the best. Okay, and let's see, Indoor Shoe Gaming, cool. Hey, Indoor Shoe Gaming, he's in our Twitch chat, of course.
Hello.
Okay. All right, so hopefully we'll see Coldust here a little bit later. I don't know exactly what's going on, but that was why we didn't have a pre-show. But I've already idled on long enough, and I've been talking way too much. Does anybody have any other What's Up, Brony, before we go on to the news?
Oh, just sat in customer service for 11 hours straight to return a part because they sent me a bad return link.
11 hours.
Yeah.
Wow.
I admire that. I have to admire that.
It was a lot of work too, so it wasn't too bad, honestly. So I just kind of had my headset going and worked.
Oh, well, that's not too bad either.
No. But today it rained all day, so came home and I was soaked and cold because it was in the mid-60s all day.
Take care not to get sick.
Oh, it takes more than that to get me sick, believe me.
Yeah. Actually, they already did. It
gets me sick. That's because I'm breathing it in every day, 12 hours a day. Not 12, that'd be amazing. 24 hours a day.
All right. Oh, yeah. Cloud of Dakota Quest. He did mention something. Legends of Equestria. Oh, wow. Okay, so yeah, it looks like they did their closing ceremony for the Summer Games. Again, I feel terrible. I didn't get a chance to take a look at that, and I'm really annoyed.
I've actually been addicted to a new game called Nexomon. It's on the Switch.
Sounds like some sort of monster.
It's a Pokemon clone. They're not too shy about admitting that in the humor in the game. I gotta say, it's pretty different. Enough not to get Nintendo after them, but it's pretty enjoyable. Because, and it actually is a breath of fresh air because I've been having a lot of fun with it.
Nice. But yeah, indoor.
Also, a thunderstorm earlier last week also hit a tree in my backyard, and now I have a big branch in it.
Yeah. But yeah, Indoor Shoe. We played Doom yesterday for our Let's Play stream. It's actually another team that's usually handled by a Winchester that does Wednesdays in Armor 3 or other shenanigans. But yeah, no, I love them. They're awesome guys. We have multiple people that stream onto this because it's kind of network in a weird way. We do many different things, so we actually have a schedule set up. Though I really
hence why the Brony Show is the main thing, but the Brony Show Network is its own thing. We want almost a full week streaming.
Well, that's also why our Twitch stream is actually restreaming off of my personal Twitch when we do the Let's Plays instead of this. But still, still, I'm glad you could check us out, Indoor. And if you want to check out the gaming streams, just keep an eye out on them. But if you also want to check out this shenanigans, go for it. And they're probably going to talk about Arma and the Twitch chat now. So let's go ahead and move on.
Commander just did. Hi, Commander.
That's why I see where this is going real fast. So.
Well, I'll be back in a bit. See you later.
Okay.
All right.
And does anybody have any other What's Up, Brony, before we go ahead and start talking some news?
Now I'm good.
All right. So let's go ahead and talk some news here. We're going to start off with a heads up on Pony Wars. This is the collectible card game that is currently being developed by our friend Drata Arcana. The Kickstarter for the collectible card game is going to be stopping in about 7 days, so you have a week left to go. They've already reached their funding goal, so pretty much anything else they get is just going to be extra cake to help things going. But
it's not a bad thing, considering they do have physical stuff, and sometimes shipping can be a bead.
Well, yeah, all of the Kickstarter stuff here is for physical cards, so none of it is digital content, which some people may be interested in. And they are planning on also bringing this around to different conventions and hoping to make something of it. And I'm really, I kind of hope they do. It'd be fun to have a lot more different games and stuff that we can get behind. But yeah, if any of you are interested at all in this Kickstarter, I would recommend jumping into it. There is only a week left, and then after that, you'll have to wait and hope that he is able to get extra copies out and start putting it into the convention line.
Or, wait for them to put it on Tabletop Sim and try it out there.
Well, he's already on Tabletop Simulator, and you can try it out there. But yeah, check it out on Tabletop Simulator if you're curious about the game and you want to get a better idea of it before you commit money. Because, money doesn't fly everywhere, right?
What? No, it just goes everywhere.
Anyway. Okay.
What?
All right. Now, really quick. Does anybody remember what online conventions are going to be happening soon?
Aside from PonyFest, Hasbro's doing one.
Well, yeah, we're going to be bringing into that, but I'm talking about more of the community ones.
Ciderfest can be the online only, remember?
Yeah, we got Cider... Okay, so let's see. I guess we'll have to go through these as we can. PonyFest, the online convention is set for September 19th. That's in a few weeks. Hopefully, you'll be able to attend. Of course, it's completely online, so... It's not going to be too hard to attend it as long as you have an internet connection that is working at that time.
Next weekend, I believe, is the Hasbro one.
Right, we'll get to that in a moment here because we haven't exactly mentioned that just yet. Ciderfest, though, they are currently actually asking for people to submit a survey. Thank you. Resume was coming into my head for some reason. They're asking people to send in a survey that they have posted on information on when they want to do the convention. Right now, they are still slightly slated for 30th to November 1st online, but they also want to check with people and see what people think, if they want to actually have that at those times or maybe stretch it out somewhere else. Okay, and online UK PonyCon, that's the one that was coming to mind here. That one's also coming up in October.
I don't know about the Burning Mares if they're doing round 3.
They are. I'm going to look at it again. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. But yeah, I'm just going over.
Yeah.
Right. So yeah. So UK PonyCon Line, that is going to be online in about 10th and 11th October. So if you are interested in that, again, keep an eye out there. Second verse, same as the first. And finally, Burning Mare has set their dates for September 25th and 26th. So that's going to be a week after Ponyfest, if my calculations are correct there. So, yeah, we got Ponyfest, and you got Burning Man. Then UK Online will be a little bit later, and then Ponyville Cider Fest will be happening shortly after that. So plenty of pony, even for the holidays or pre-holidays. We'll go pre-holidays.
During the holidays, because with Cyberfest, if it's going through October, this end and November's beginning, we have Halloween.
All right. Yep. And wait, what?
Hey, Cole.
Cole.
Hey, Cole.
We have Coldust. We didn't even need to summon him this time.
Hi.
Coldust. So, Coldust, how are you doing? Apparently you had some issues and came to the pre-show.
It's a plumbing situation that I have to deal with that is really annoying, and I basically can't fix it until the end of the week. It's annoying. Life is annoying. Let's not focus on it.
You know what? I agree. Instead, we're going to go ahead. We're going to focus on Toa, who kept interrupting something and providing wrong information at the same time.
Toa, so, it was on September.
It was, but it's not next week. Hasbro is running an online convention. They have recently announced it, Hasbro PulseCon. And this one will be on the 25th and 26th. Now, of course,
I think the next week after Ponyfest.
Actually, I'm not sure what you said. You kept interrupting me.
You said it's the next week after Ponyfest, you think.
Thank you!
Well, welcome.
Everybody's turning against me. Okay.
One side, except for my own.
All right.
I do shoot off, but call occasionally.
And I do appreciate it. Thank you.
No problem. Shimutoa rising. Okay, so...
I also appreciate art from you, Circuit. Just saying. I appreciate all the art. Y'all are amazing.
Well, I guess that works then. Okay, so getting back on track here. Yes, I'm trying to get through the news in a timely manner for once. Heaven help us. Hasbro is doing an online convention. Why is this important to us? Because Hasbro talks pony, and we want to know what pony they want to talk about. So, they may have some more information about the new Pony of Season 5 as well as the movie, which they actually have announced a few things, which we will get to, so please patience until we actually get there. And instead, let's go ahead and talk merchandise, where all the real money from the franchise is made.
Yes, the merchandising.
Merchandising. In this case, Pony Kisses! I just wanted to let that sit there for a second.
Wait, hang on. What did you just say? I was distracted by typing in chat.
Pony Kisses. I said Pony Kisses.
Pony Kisses. Circuit. Have body pillows advanced. I'm scared.
Actually, they have, but they have in ways that you really don't want to know. But in this case, this is actually a more pleasant retail surprise. Hershey Kisses have now little treasure chests that you can find in some stores that contain either a pony figure or Autobot. Well, Transformers figure. It's probably not just Autobots.
But does it come with the kiss inside? That's the question I want to know.
There is a kiss inside. You will get your you will get your dirty chocolate with the pony. And heaven help you if you have it in a hot car. You just open it up and you see you see Pinkie Pie just drowning in chocolate, and you just take a photo and put it on Instagram, and then it gets weird.
Then it gets viral and messed up.
Yeah.
She would enjoy the chocolate, if we're being honest.
Yeah, but just seeing a little mini Pinkie Pie like drowning in her melted chocolate kiss is just there's something disturbing about that, but it might also be me.
Hey, does this remind you of season one? Click.
Oh, dear world, it would actually remind you of season one, wouldn't it?
Yep.
Chocolate rain.
Actually, that's season two, but...
I was thinking the chocolate fountain.
Oh, right.
Okay, the chocolate fountain works.
Yes.
Not Chocolate Rain. Good try, though.
No, Chocolate Rain was a good one, but...
I've forgotten more than I remember. So.
No, it's okay. Instead, let's go ahead and remember this. The My Little Pony, Mighty Morphin Pink Power Ranger Pony is now available for pre-order or order.
That is a mouthful.
I know, right? But yes, it is now available for order / pre-order in the United States, so we don't have to cross international borders, which we can't really do right now, to pick up this figure. So you can pre-order it right now on Entertainment Earth, Hasbro Pulse, and also my favorite toy store, Big Bad Toy Store, where I'm not getting paid by them yet, but I'm hoping that they will be willing to do so if I say their name enough. Big Bad Toy Store.
You never know. You never know. Also, it could be what it could be. The Pinkie Pie, the Mighty Morphing Pink Pony Ranger.
Actually, I'm not going to lie. I would love to see a season of Power Rangers where they were all ponies. Could you imagine what that would be like?
Well,
they've done dinosaurs. They've done cars. They've done the Jurassic period.
They fucking did trains of all
They things. Did trains at one point, yeah.
Oh, come on. It's Japan. It's Japan. Trains wouldn't exactly be a difficult thing. No. Japan, I would think that the crazy thing would be...
Well, in fairness, during Mahou Sentai Magiranger, they did have at least two different people become centaurs. I'm not kidding.
You know what? Yeah. I think that did it. I did it. We got the centaur. We got centaurs. I think we did it. That's it. We're gonna just stop right there and move on at this point.
That was over.
And one of them was actually a unicorn.
But in all honesty, though, I did pre-order this off of Big Bad Toy Store, so I'm expecting mine within next month. And it's not a bad price either. It's like $15-16 for it.
Honestly, that's not bad. It looks like a pretty quality thing.
Oh no, it looks really good quality, and I'm excited for it.
Sadly, I gotta pour all my money into my truck if I want any hope of it being done before snow starts falling.
Let's see. That's what's shocking. MLP didn't have a crossover with much. The fans were the ones that made the crossovers, not the actual writers. True. True. The fans made a lot of the crossovers. However, we will get back to that in a moment. But first...
Okay, I'm putting that in my cap.
But first, one last little bit of merchandise here. Toy Kingdom has Baby Rainbow Dash and Twilight Sparkle Plush. Is.
Actually, that does look as horrifying as I thought. But I remember Spike the Baby Dragon toy.
And I don't know, that like bag thing for the neck, whatever. Yeah, that looks pretty horrifying.
It kind of looks like they're regular ponies, but their faces got stung by bees. So just like swollen up.
Oh, in fairness, how do you plushify that design for baby folds?
Circuit, is that bottom one a butt?
Oh, no.
It's like, I'm looking at that. It looks like one of those neck comforters for like long rides or something.
Exactly.
Is it Rainbow just eating it?
That is exactly it. It is actually a neck pillow.
Oh.
And then there's just Rainbow eating it. It's great.
Because to me, it looked like a pony butt with a face on the end. But anyways.
I can see that, too. I see that going.
I can actually see that now. And dang it, yeah. I can see that now.
embrace it.
But yeah, these are for three-year-olds and stuff, so I don't expect to see these in airports for you to buy for $20 for an airline. I don't see that
That's
happening.
Being particularly generous. Come on, you need to do at least 50 before you get on the plane.
Oh, if you want the premium ones, those are
100
easy.
Ugh.
Actually, I am kind of curious there. How much is this?
Quickly Google it.
Okay, money converter. Google for all of your needs. Okay, so we want this much money, and not in euro, but see, this is supposed to be
US dollar.
No, it's.
That should be easy.
Well, that's not... No, I mean, yeah, we want it in the US dollar, but it's what it's coming from that we don't... That I'm trying to figure out.
What is the P?
just hit and then to US dollar.
But
just try that.
Oh, dear.
That's honestly one thing I hate about going to airports or any huge things like that. Really, anything where a huge group of people come together and they're waiting for stuff.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's not giving me much because all of the currency has three letters after it. So, let's see. Well, let's see. This is from the Philippines. Okay, let's see.
Let's see what you're clicking on it. Yeah.
The Filipino P.
The Philippine peso, okay. Or the PHP. Wow, PHP, really? Well, that is really okay.
I took my headphones off for a moment, put them back on, and the first thing I hear is Filipino P.
Yeah, well, trying to convert money.
Peso.
Yeah, the Filipino peso, normally just referred to with the P sign or the PI.
Wow, really? That much? Okay, so yeah, apparently it's $7.22 for that thing.
The current rate of the peso is 0.021 US dollars.
Yes, it's abysmally low. So yeah, if you go to the Philippines, you could get that for cheap. Take that, airplanes!
Yeah. A poor man in the US is a rich man in the Philippines.
Alright, so...
Gary.
So, as it was mentioned, crossovers between MLP and anything else are rare. Well, we just got a preview for Transformers Friendship in Disguise Issue 2. The My Little Pony Transformers crossover that nobody saw coming.
That everyone wanted.
I don't know if everybody wanted it, but it definitely is interesting enough.
Have you... Oh my...
The illustration's good enough that I think people would be just excited for how good it looks.
Also, I'm loving the fact that Spike is like, my favorite one is Grimlock. Screw everybody else, Grimlock is best robot.
However, some of you may be wondering, okay, I haven't picked up the first issue yet. I don't know if I'm going to like this, and I don't want to spend $5 for the comic or however much it is. Humble Bundle has you covered. Because currently, Humble Bundle right now has the IDW crossover Humble Bundle. And surprisingly enough, My Little Pony Transformers Issue 1 is on there for the $1 version. So you can spend $1 to get a few Humble Bundle comics, including the Transformer My Little Pony Issue 1 of the crossover.
Also, I love the fact that they are doing another Transformers G.I. Joe crossover. It's just good stuff.
I mean, they do a lot of them. Is it really that good? I don't know.
The fact that they have giant weapons to fight with them that can actually think and have moral decisions. Yeah, I think it's sounding good.
I don't know, but we are talking about G.I. Joe. They shoot everything with lasers, but they basically have the same aiming as a stormtrooper.
Red lasers and blue lasers. It's the exact same.
keep firing suppressive fire. Why? We can't hit any of them. yeah. So let's go ahead and pull a pin out of another thing that we talked about a moment ago. Generation 5. The new generation of My Little Pony is set to be coming out in September of next year, so we have 1 year until the movie of the next generation comes out. And they have confirmed that there is going to be a brand new cast for this. They've also confirmed that it looks like it's going to be computer animated. So whether that means it'll still be in a flash animation or they're going for this full CG route, I don't know.
They could also do Toon Boom like Rainbow Road Trip.
That's kind of what I meant by Flash. Granted, Flash is a really poor choice, especially since that's not going to exist in 4 months. So
it was good 10 years ago.
It was good.
Started making the show. Yeah.
Oh, dude, it was good during the old days of online like product.
It's still good. It's still good. The problem is it has security problems and they can't fix it.
It's out of date now compared to like what Toon Boom is and stuff like that, but yeah.
No, Indoor Shoe, that this was just a cover image. We have no idea who they're using for the main cast. We could actually see ponies we've never heard of before.
And I'm fine with that because that's kind of what they did with Generation 4. Granted, there are some carryovers, but...
Well, I mean, they may have the same name, but they're not going to be the same pony in any regard. And I'm hoping that Hasbro does treat it with proper care and doesn't just try to shovel a cartoon down throats to sell toys.
Yes, buy our toys. Who cares about the story? Yeah. So, you're going to kill your audience, people.
I am down for another escapism type of thing. And I'm also down if we go a little bit cyberpunk or magic punk with it.
They're not going to do that. They are not going to do that.
I'm excited for, honestly, new characters because... Well, even the voice actors were tired of playing the same characters for 10 years.
I'm excited for different characters, a different world to explore, and hopefully an actual world and an actual story there. You know, it doesn't need to be Avatar. Just please don't make it Generation 3.5.
No.
I'll even take Generation 3, just not 3.5. Yeah, and not Pony Life. I like Pony Life. Pony Life is good as just mental sugar, which it basically is just stupid, sweet stuff that you can just watch for 5 minutes and turn off your brain and enjoy it. But don't make the entire Generation 5 out of that, please.
But you know they're going to make merch out of this regardless.
Oh, no, I get that. They are. You know what? I get that's that. That's all Hasbro does.
They make toys and then they sell, and then they make videos and whatnot.
I accept that 100%, and I'm okay with that. In fact, a good show will always sell merch. That's always a good thing. The thing is, you have to have a good show to sell good merch. You can have all the merch in the world, but if it's not a good show, it's not going to go anywhere. We have seen this time and again.
Second, may I remind you of Thundercats, Symbiote Titan...
Good show, except for Roar.
Megas XLR.
Good show.
Okay. Now here's the thing. How much merch actually got pushed for those shows? Basically, that's an example of the network not backing its own product.
Thundercats did get a good one for the 2011 one, but... No one bought it, apparently,
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah, they do have a toy, though, but, oh, wow. Somebody is selling it for, like, $475 on eBay.
I can 3D print Megas cheaper than that.
We're going to take your word for it, but let's go ahead and move on here. Generation 5 is exciting. I'm hoping that we'll see good stuff. Right now, though, we just got little snippets. There might be actual images and stuff to go off of at the Hasbro convention, but we'll have to wait and see.
Yeah.
Now, for those of you who love music and love being able to contribute to Pony Music, Brony musicians, the mega compilation album of State of Sugar Chocolate has come out. Of course, this is one of...
We're just talking about chocolate.
Yeah. Chocolate! Chocolate! Sorry.
So, and of course they would do that for the image. Of course they would.
I'll leave it be. It's a music album. But yes, this is... Now, let's... A little announcer voice. This is 50 albums. 50 different songs on one digital album that you can pay whatever you want in order to get all of this for you. DRM free, downloadable anytime you wish, yours to keep forever, as long as Bandcamp doesn't close its doors, unless you download it. But yes, $50 songs, and you can pay a single dollar. I paid a single dollar, but then again, I also bought their entire album, and I've given them a little bit more money than just a single dollar, but it is a lot of great music. Different varieties, different mix-ups, different artists. So you can even see if there are some artists that you might be interested in.
That's always the good thing about compilation albums. You can see what your tastes are and who you're like, oh, I want to get more of this stuff, or nah, I don't like that stuff.
You can also just listen to it. You can go down and even listen to them if you want.
Just listen to it before you buy it.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's a little loud, and I have no way of controlling the volume on this, so that's why... Unfortunately, this is why we don't play these in the background to try to share them off a little more, because I would love to.
Yeah, you go and turn it on, all of a sudden your ears are bleeding.
Yeah, your ears are bleeding, and I can't do anything about it. Bandcamp does not have a volume control on the demo here. I could download the songs and play them separately. I don't do that. Why? Because I keep forgetting.
How dare you!
Also, so,
we can only have a lot of stuff running in the background.
But in any case, that is going to be it for the news. Hooray! We actually managed to get through it rather quickly this time.
What? Is not 8:30 by the time we're done?
Yeah, but we still got a few things to go off of. Now, before we would normally talk about Pony Life, however, considering that we're going to be doing a tabletop game, I decided to exercise a course of caution, and we're going to sideline Pony Life until next week. Ooh. Talking about the next episode. So apologies to anybody that watched episodes 5 and 6. We will be talking about that next week.
We're sorry you had to watch them.
Yep.
unless you actually legitimately enjoyed them, then we're just sorry you had to waste about 20 minutes of your life.
Well, honestly, as you said, it's mental sugar, and given the other mental sugar we have to compare it with, it's not that bad.
I suppose so, yeah. But in any case, we're going to go quickly talk a little bit about the challenge of the week. Coldust, are you ready for the challenge of the week?
Oh, hey. No, I am not ready at all.
All right.
Boy, you better get ready.
All right, next segment then. All right, so in the next segment... Okay.
Next time on the Brony Show.
Will they finally shut up the robot? The answer is no.
Toakoi, did you give me the right link?
That should be right to the... thing.
Yeah, but that's not the challenge we had this week.
There's a reason. And look at the description.
I'll get to that in a moment. Alright, so, I don't know what happened. So, the challenge of the week, for this week, of course, was, first day of school. And we also had the protest initiative challenge.
Ah, yes, the protest initiative challenge, which was Bones.
Bones.
Bones. And
also on the website it says getting ready for school.
Bones.
Close enough.
Bones.
Getting ready for school. But Bones is definitely there. Okay.
Dem bones.
But yes, that was the challenge, and I was able to actually get mine drawn up way early today, so I had time to work a little bit on the details here. Now, of course...
Yeah, there's two images, and there's one thing missing from it.
Yeah, I know. I missed one, the small thing, until after I uploaded it. But so, yeah, in this case, waking up for school. Right now, I'm basically in training at my work, so this is my mornings every single day for my kind of school. Work school. So, basically, disheveled shirt, disheveled myself, and a giant cup of coffee to try to wake up. I decided to include the bones, and my excuse that is the night before having a wild chicken wing party.
Dude, those stains are going to stay.
Also, dude, if those are in comparison to the size of your pony, that's a huge fucking chicken.
What did you do? I think you had turkey bones and turkey wings or whatever.
Well, he might have had some cockatrice. I don't know how he got it, but somehow someone got it.
Just reminds me of the fried chicken in BoJack Horseman, which is absolutely huge because...
Reasons.
Yeah. So,
Well, of course, they're also genetically modifying chickens left and right here, so that's my excuse.
Big bones.
Big old chicken bones. So in any case, there's...
Chickens in Equestria? More likely than you think.
So yeah, that was my little attempt at the entry here. Since I challenge everybody, I want to join the challenge with everybody. Unfortunately, we didn't get any entries outside of Toa's, which is unrelated. Acting skill. Which apparently I'm taking acting classes and I'm using, and I don't have a skull, so I'm using Toa's robotic head instead. So I'm guessing Toa went for the protest challenge.
Wait, Toa, one question. So does that, is that a replacement part head? Or do you, is that just like a head exoskeleton that you can put over your head? Like, is that
it's
like...
I'm sticking with the robot explanation, and my head is detachable.
I'm sorry, I don't care if the original, it's supposed to be a skull. That does not count as a bone.
Let's go bowling.
Oh my gosh, that could be bowling. Bowling with heads.
There you go, bowling with heads.
I don't know, for some reason, my mind is going more to Red Dwarf and this image here.
Oh, it's probably
trying to think why. There you go.
Yeah.
With your extra heads.
Yes, the extra heads.
I'm like, why would it bring it up with Red Dwarf than a? Oh yeah, right. That happened.
Yeah, you never know.
But in any case, so that was some Toa's entry. Unfortunately, we didn't get any other entries. But like I said, August has just been one of those exhausting months for a lot of people. It's either gone really fast and blazingly so, or really slow and painfully so. So
mine was the painfully, where you were walking across the desert and never found the end.
mine was just the pain where it just like things changed in horrible, painful ways, and I'm slowly trying to come to grips
and
with the loss.
Then there's my dealing with my grandmother, leukemia.
So we're gonna go ahead, and I think all of us need a breather. We need a break. We need something relaxing. So I decided for our next week's challenge, big fluffy pillows.
Yes.
Oh, I get to bring out the cold docky pillow.
Uh-oh.
No, it's the coffee pillow.
Oh, actually, this is perfect. Okay, I am going to give credit to this because I also previously with the challenges, I did welcome people just grabbing random images that fit in it and didn't have to make it themselves just for something fun. But yeah, here we go. Here's one that Textalion found. We're just going to have that sitting there while we ask the all-important question, what is our protest initiative challenge?
Protest initiative challenge this week is bones. No, I'm kidding.
Bones.
Bones. Again. Bones again.
Bones. No.
Bones.
More bones.
Protest initiative challenge. Since we are now rolling into September, the challenge is what you can't remember happened in September.
Ooh, Green Day. I love it.
Too much, man.
I'm shooting for that old song, you know, I can't remember.
September.
When everything is gone, when it's dark and I'm alone.
We're
going full throwback, but also with a joke. Whatever you can't remember happened in September. This could be anything at all. As long as you couldn't remember that it happened in September.
What happens in Las Pegasus stays in Las Pegasus.
But also remember that you gotta wake up when September ends.
That's Green Day.
There you go.
That's a really good Green Day song.
Party of September too.
I'm not. Somebody September songs. I was gonna say, I am not in the mental capacity right now to try and figure out how to fit Earth, Wind, and Fire in here too.
I was like Earth, Wind, and Fire. I'm like, how do you even fit it? I can't remember the lyrics. It's been so long.
Dang it! Now I want to remember that song because it's really awesome, but I can't remember it.
It's great, isn't it? It's like the words.
Oh my god, that could be something you can't remember.
That's true.
That is too good.
Let's see.
The possibilities are endless this week. It just has to be something that you can't remember happened in September.
Do you remember?
Fire asking, do you remember?
Do you remember?
Oh,
There you go. I can't play anything else. I literally can't play anything else because it'll get us blocked. I only play like there 3 seconds.
The official video.
Thank you, Deathlight.
Do you September the 21st night of September? Oh, Septemberception! It's Septemberception, everybody.
Billy Talent's Falling Leaves comes to mind because of that music video.
Okay.
How is September so musically based?
Because it's the fall. People like the fall way more than they like the summer.
It's true.
But we have at least 3 different songs about
love September. A good downfall.
The fall is better than summer or winter, you know.
All right, so
summer is like summer.
And spring sucks. It's just muddy all the time.
You see, here's the thing: summer is super fun when you're a kid, but when you're older, you still have to work, and it's hot, which just makes work even worse. Fall is nice because it's cooling down, and you can laugh at all the children who are going back to school and be like, "Ha ha, I'm not you."
There's also pumpkin spice.
See, Cole, there's a problem with that where I live. No, fall here just means it gets even hotter until 2 weeks before winter happens, and then you get 2 weeks of what you're talking about, and then it's winter.
Okay, so it's that's
how you get a good cold.
September is normally hot, but it can be occasionally cool.
Trot with me through the autumn leaves. That is a great song.
I fucking love that song.
It is awesome.
So trot with me through the autumn leaves.
Keep
close to stay warm. God, I love that song.
It's amazing how we still find ways to make this show last a long.
I know. I'm trying so hard.
It just happens.
I'm trying so hard to make us pace well. All right,
Circuit, just look at it this way. This is the Brony Show, and we're talking about ponies right now, for the most part.
Yeah. True enough.
Pony-related content and pony-inspired
content. Also, this is what an actual conversation is like, not just a fabricated, recorded one.
I know. Fabricated, recorded. What the...
Yeah, because, you know, this is 100% fabricated and recorded.
Oh, you're so funny.
I am not a robot.
Actually, the only one who is in a
robot. Edited thing. We didn't script any of this. Nope, never. We would.
No, actually. No, CMC. No, CMC's got it right. CMC actually got it right, but in the wrong way. All of us are actually robots. The irony is Toa is the only one that isn't a robot. That's why he keeps trying to convince everybody. He keeps trying to convince everybody he's a robot because he's the only one that isn't.
Does not compute. Must burn.
I'm just gonna bring up one thing. I'm just gonna bring up one thing, and then I'm gonna say we move on. But the conversation actually made me think of that joke in Dilbert from the Y2K episode. Are you saying I'm so predictable that you can pre-record all our conversations? Yes, you're so predictable that I can pre-record all our conversations.
Oh, I want to get the Dilbert DVDs. I love the Dilbert animated show. I don't know why
it was good.
It was good.
Yeah, as long as you always remember what the keyword is.
I have the series collection on my shelf.
Well, let's go ahead and move on here. We're going now. Our actual little fun event that we're going to be having today is we're going to be playing a tabletop simulator version of Prince. But before we do that, I do have a few pictures here that I want to go through. Now, during the summer, no problem. So now
but
during the
continue.
Right.
There you can go now. It's fine.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt him.
I know, but this has been going on all episodes. So
let's go.
So yes, all summer we've been having pony convention after pony convention, and pretty much every single online convention I bought something. I probably spent more money this time around than I have in any of my other convention goings, including hotels and everything. So this is kind of funny in a weird way. So I just, now that I have almost everything delivered finally, I decided it would be fun to just go through all of the different fun merch that you could probably still pick up or at least take a look at. And, you know, and with the few more conventions that are still coming down in September, maybe find something that you may be interested in jumping on. Now, of course, you can see right here, I got a few here already from, I got Karen Beer. That was actually from the Japanese Pony Convention. I got plenty of the mascot for, blah, blah, blah. Pony Net. What? I'm just going to start.
Ponies Online.
Yeah, Pony. Or... Yeah, it's Pony Fest Online. Yeah.
Pony Fest. Yeah. Yeah. That was a lot of stuff.
I spot some stuff from Midair Pony Fair, so I'm very proud of you.
Oh, yes, Midair Pony Fair. I got a few other things, too. And one thing that I'm actually partially proud of, the bottom, I say partially, seriously, Quantum Sea Pony Con, which was unfortunately the one thing we couldn't exactly cover too much of because the server got overcrowded. But I did manage to grab a badge for the Quantum Sea Pony Con, which was on the Minecraft server. So there you go. I got Circuit on a Sea Pony Con badge. Also, the Everfree Northwest postcard here, which is hilarious because this is a postcard for a convention that never happened. They had a ton of them, and they were actually giving them away for a $2 donation. So I picked one up just because the irony of having a card for a convention that unfortunately did not happen. And there's actually a close-up of the pin there that I got from Captain Showtime. It's actually kind of funny. I bought the pin, and I put in a pre-order for the pin, which the pre-order got canceled. But then Captain Showtime actually had them suddenly show up on his doorstep out of nowhere. So he shipped them to everybody free of charge that actually pre-ordered. So that was really awesome of him. And I got two pins out of it. Also, Traveling Pony Museum got a bunch of stickers, swag, figures, and a lanyard. Also, I would check them out. They got a lot of cool little buttons and stickers for Fallout Equestria, especially if you like Fallout Equestria. Also, here's a few more from Midair Pony Fair, as well as Burning Mare, TrotCon Online. I got a few from TrotCon Online as well. And also a Utah Brony badge from Choco Pony.
Bagley would go nuts over that burp sticker.
Oh, yeah. I did. I'm surprised that came for free out of Traveling Pony Museum. If you actually buy something from them and ask for it, they could probably give you one of the burp stickers. Let Bagley know.
Which I haven't seen them all night.
He'll pop up before... Actually, I saw him earlier, so I'm sure he'll pop up before you least expect it. But yeah, Choco Pony, this was one of the big reasons I didn't take the pictures earlier, because it took me forever to get the merch from him. The problem is, I ordered it just before the con season actually started, but he had problems getting the merchandise out. He kept in communication with me throughout the entire ordeal because there was a lot of back and forth. You know, I haven't gotten it yet. Okay, let me see what's going on. Has it been sent out yet? No, it hasn't. Do you know what might be happening? Can you give me an update? Sorry, we haven't figured out what's going on. And eventually, here we go. Now, I originally just got the coin and Twilight in a bottle because I thought it was really cute. And he was awesome enough to throw in a couple of the badges, a bookmark, and a pack of the shipping card right up there. So yeah, big shout out to Choco Pony. That was really awesome of him. Buy his stuff. And here's a few more little things here. A lot of stickers, a lot of buttons, a lot of Pony Fest stuff. I also got a Zippo lighter from Metallurgy. What? You see, this is what happens when you play too many video games and watch too much anime and you become older. You forget everything.
Sweet will do that to you as well.
Sleep will definitely do that.
No sweets.
Oh, what? I like my chocolate mint cake, didn't you? But it's a Zippo lighter from My Little Ties. Thank you. Yeah, Zippo lighter, as well as an awesome dice there. That's actually a Discord dice. It is completely useless. Because every time you roll it, it's just a random weird symbol or Discord's face. It has no use. It's actually hilarious.
Nice.
I love it.
Beautiful.
But yeah.
Vigilante is watching you.
a lot of Bitray, a lot of Ponyfest. A lot of the different merch. Also got a Friendship University sticker you can see right there, just because F you. How could you not get a sticker to get that?
U.
Friendship University, F you. Good old F you. I don't know where I'm going to stick that, but I want to stick it somewhere great.
How did Hasbro get away with that?
I don't think they realized it.
Well, here's the thing. The Flip Flam brothers had the University of Friendship, UF, while Twilight has the School of Friendship.
Okay, so they basically swapped it around, so it's not Friendship University, it's the University of Friendship.
Yes, I believe so, just because they thought, hey, wait.
Maybe.
I must remind everyone that Prince University of Central Kansas spelled out that word, and they didn't realize it until later.
Maybe.
My headcanon is that ponies don't actually know the meaning of the F word, only the Equestrian Girls universe.
Let's see. That'd be cool if there was a Discord six-sider. It would be awesome. It actually would be awesome. I thought it was a Discord six-sider. I thought it was like normal five, and then you had one symbol of choice for one edge. But no, it's just a literal dice of random. But I like this one. Skeptical Applejack. Truth Seeker Applejack. Truth Seeker Applejack. Yeah.
I still like Skeptical Jack better.
But. No, there was a better word for it. It's not Truth Seeker. It's like a conspiracy theorist Applejack, I think. Anyway, moving right along here. Let's see. There's another picture of all the stuff that I got from my little ties. Got a coin from him as well. I've been collecting a lot of coins lately. That's kind of the weird thing, but I like them. I think the coins are fun. A few more close-ups of some of these, or am I going backwards? I'm going backwards. That explains it. Moving back where we're at. A few more attendee badges. I got a lot of the attendee badges just because I wanted to show off that these online conventions were happening, and I thought they were pretty cool. Also got some stickers of Bytechilla, which is like a little creature that was messing with Bit right there. You can see I also got Discord and the Animaniacs. I got Twilight Sparkle on a Friendship Bomb. And I managed to pick up 3 comics of Silly Lyra, which is a really fun series if you haven't checked it out on Tumblr. And now I got prints of it. Yeah, I got prints of it, which I'm so happy for.
Discord versus the Animaniacs.
Oh, yeah. Discord versus...
I'm sorry. I'm not sure who wins.
Nobody wins on that one. Nobody would win. Except for the viewing audience. But yeah, there you could get a better look at the Bytechillas. I don't know. I thought that in this particular badge, it just looked stupid adorable. So I had to get the badge at least.
They do, Sagitt. They really do.
Yeah. And here, these aren't great pictures. Apologies. But here are some pixel crafts that I got from, I forget his name, but he is on Etsy. He makes a lot of pixel crafts of different ponies as well as different games. Got
someone else is a fan of Dragon Quest.
I was about to say, either someone's thinking there's a fusion of Gotenks and Trunks, or that's Dragon Quest.
That's Dragon Quest. I believe it's actually the main character in the anime series, or a manga series. The funny thing is, he's opposite of Zazma from Dragon Quest III. And also, I got a pair of shoes from BabsCon that I can't wear because they're unfortunately size 13, which is not a size 13. I don't know how to describe it, but I can't wear them. They're too small. And Ashante.
You're a Ashante fan.
I am a Ashante fan. I think her games are great. I like the Metroidvania style and the animation is cute.
WayForward does a great job with her games.
Oh no, WayForward does an amazing job, which is why I was really curious why they went with Beyblade, but I'm leaving that alone. That's my crux. Another pony fan out there. I got a bunch of Ponified anime pictures here. My Pony Academia. Shield Pony, the slime one. I can't remember. The time I got reincarnated as a slime.
Yeah,
Podified?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. And also the Legend of Celestia. I just could not resist that.
Breath of the Mild.
Yeah.
There's no mild behavior underneath her cloak.
Yep. And also I got the Daybreaker because it just looked really nice. And it was
Daybreaker is always good. And I will say Midnight Sun also has a neat design, but Daybreaker, that's kind of cool.
Okay, now this one took a long time for me to get, and I was worried I didn't, so I was happy when it finally came in the mail 2 months later. During BabsCon, Brony chef actually had a small online store with his cookbooks as well as a few other things. I got all of his cookbooks. Cooking with Babs, the Brony Chef cookbook, Mixology is Magic, Cooking with Kindness, all of them. All of his cookbooks are now in my possession, as well as the Japonism book that you can see right there on the left. I also got that from Babs. That came straight from Japan, also with the Kirin beer. A quick show off here, The Other Side of Ponyism, as well as The Other Side of One of the Cookbooks, as well. This poster I got from Rat of Drawn. Or Rat of Dawn, I can't remember.
Thank you for the 9 wonderful years of
Rat of Dawn.
Yeah, Rat of Dawn. I wanted to get this poster ever since I saw it over at, I think, Babs last year. But every time it came down to it, I spent all my money on other things, so I'd never had the chance. And I finally got the chance now, so I grabbed it. And these I had a special order from a board game creation store, Thunderdrome and Palomino Gold. Some of you guys might remember Palomino Gold.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, physical copies of these games that I can play whenever I want. Really cool stuff.
Yeah, the game that kind of glitched on a...
Yeah. Why does the Palomino Gold look like a box of Altoids?
It actually is the shape of a box of Altoids. It's really amazing.
That's what it crossed my mind.
It is. It is exactly the shape of a box of Altoids. And considering how the size of the little gold pieces, it doesn't surprise me that they used like the same shape as a box of Altoids, but it makes it easy to carry. It's really easy to carry. Really fun.
Just don't mix them up with your Altoids.
That too, yeah. Okay, these are some fun ones. I got the remaining 10 that I didn't get from Fiora the Tank Girl. I actually got a couple of expansions of Cards Against Humanity, My Little Pony Edition. This is a third expansion that actually came out from, I can't remember his name now. Captain Showtime? No, I don't think that's not it. Anyway, but yeah, he's made several of them, but I don't have the first or second expansions, which I'm hoping show up eventually. But yeah, I got that as well as the Cards Against FIM or... Not FIM. Fan fiction website. And the pins button, the pins, the little small print, everything of that there actually came from a Brony that was doing a large loot crate kind of thing in Malaysia. That one took a while to get, and this kind of a set, you can see right there at the bottom, there's one that's completely white. That one I'm kind of bummed out on. It was the Pegasus that was the best friend of the one that couldn't fly. You know, the one that's actually really skilled. And in the
Vapor Trail or what was?
Vapor Trail. It's Vapor Trail. That was it. Thank you.
Ah, okay.
But yeah, that was Vapor Trail. And somehow I don't know what happened, but when I went to finally take pictures of this after getting it a month later, it faded out. It's almost completely white now.
Oh, so it had color before.
Oh, it had great color. It looked great. Luckily, nothing else did that. And this was like a $10 box that I got from Malaysia. I paid more for shipping than I did for the merch.
But that's often the case.
Yeah, but that was a little disappointing there. And also, I got comics from Captain Spitfire. No.
Captain Hook.
Not Captain Hook. I forget his name. He's also the one that made Palomino Gold and the Thunderdrome there. But he did Firestarter, Spitfire, and Sunjackers. And yeah, I got a couple of the comics that he made, as well as the first issue of Sunjackers. So really excited about that as well. And this is the other thing I got from Brony Chef. A full-size wearable chef's coat with my name, a little American flag, and also the BabsCon insignia on the sleeve. So yeah, this is probably the most crazy, weird, but also dopest merch I've gotten. That's saying something. There you go. Thank you, Commander Summit. Captain Horse. Captain Horse is the one that made Sunjackers, as well as Firestarter Spitfire, Palomino Gold, Thunderdrome, all of that fun stuff. Really great artist, really great stuff. Buy from him. Also, got a Bitrate shirt. Fits well. It's nice. It's snuggly. Stretchy. And Traveling Pony Museum, they also got some of my money. I bought a Twilight Sparkle beach towel and a Bitrate beach towel. And I believe the final couple of things, a Ponyfest Fluff Juice coffee cup. And also a Ponyfest metal mug that I got from the soda company that actually has really good sodas, but it's really expensive. Wild Bills, thank you. But yeah, Ponyfest metal mug from Wild Bills.
See a little bit of the Twilight Shrine behind you.
Yeah, the big plushy Twilight Shrine. I actually forgot about the metal mug until I was getting things cleaned up. And then I'm just like, oh, I forgot to get the picture of the mug. And I went to take a picture. And then I realized that it's reflecting. And you can actually see that I was bare-chested at the point because it was really hot. So, yeah, you guys aren't getting a peep show. I quickly put a shirt on and took a picture again.
Says, I think it's Captain Force.
No, yeah, Commander. Force,
something like that, yeah.
Yeah, I already saw that and I corrected. Again, thank you, Commander Something, for reminding me of Captain Horrors. And, yeah, that's all the fun merch that I got throughout the online conventions this year. So many merch.